Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. There was a question which was put forward about the ruling of taking a bath on the day of Jumu'ah. So as to save time and also benefit, we will take from the speech of our Shaykh Muhammad ibn Huzam hafidhahullah in his explanation of Bulugh al-Maram titled Fathul Alam. In the first volume, page number 302, he mentions in the matan, the textbook of Bulugh al-Maram, Al-Hafidh bin Hajar, he mentions the hadith, and the Shaykh, he will be explaining it. So Al-Hafidh, he mentions the hadith of Abi Sa'id Al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, which is fi al-Sahihain wa ghayrihima ghusl al-Jumu'ati wajibun ala kulli muhtalim. The bathing on the day of Jumu'ah is an obligation upon everyone who is muhtalim. Muhtalim, يعني al-Baligh, the one who has reached the age of puberty. He says, وعن Samurata ibn Jundub radiallahu anhu قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من توضع يوم الجمعة فبها ونعمت ومن اغتسل فالغسل أفضل. The one who makes wudu on the day of Jumu'ah, then بها ونعمت, this is good and sufficient. And whoever takes a bath, a ghusl, then the ghusl is أفضل, is better. This hadith was reported by الخمسة, meaning أصحاب السنن الأربعة, as well as Ahmed in his Musnad. The Shaykh, he mentions from the rulings which are benefited from the two hadith. Firstly, the ruling of the bathing on the day of Jumu'ah. There are two opinions which are strong in this regard. The first opinion being that it is an obligation, which has been reported from Abu Huraira, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, Ammar. From the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, Ibn Mundhir, he reports these opinions from them in al-Awsat. And the Shaykh, he said that this is established from them except, and this is established from them except Ammar radiallahu anhu. So this is the opinion of Abu Huraira, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, and Umar ibn Khattab from the Sahaba, and also a group from the people of knowledge, from the likes of Imam Ahmad, which is an opinion from him, also Imam Malik, and was declared to be correct by Ibn Hazm, as well as in our era, contemporary scholars, Sheikh Uthaymeen, Sheikh Muqbil, and also from what I've come across, Sheikh Al-Albani, Rahmatullahi Alayhim Jami'an. And they've used as a proof for this opinion that it is an obligation to take ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah, the hadith which we took previously of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, ghusl al-Jumu'ati wajibun ala kulli muhtalim. The bathing is an obligation upon everyone for the day of Jumu'ah who has reached the age of puberty. Likewise, the hadith of Ibn Umar في الصحيحين in Bukhari and Muslim, من أتى منكم الجمعة فليغتسل. Whoever comes to the Jumu'ah, then let him take a bath, then do the ghusl. We also have the hadith of Abi Huraira رضي الله عنه, which is متفق عليه as well. حق على كل مسلم أن يغتسل كل سبعة أيام. It is a right upon every Muslim that they take a bath once every 7 days, yani once a week. There's also another hadith that the Shaykh mentions, على كل محتلم رواح الجمعة وعلى كل من راح الجمعة الغسل. Upon everyone who is reached age of puberty is for them to go to the Jumu'ah, and upon everyone who comes to the Jumu'ah is to bath, take the ghusl. And the hadith is reported by Abu Dawood, وهو في الصحيح المسندي للوادعي. The other opinion that it is mustahab, after looking at these evidences, which are quite clear in their indication as to the obligation of taking the ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah, we have another opinion. Ala wa huwa annahu mustahab, that it's recommended. And this was the position of the majority of scholars. And it's been established from Ibn Mas'ud as well as Ibn Abbas from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and the Shaykh says that it is established from them. And they used for this several hadith, the likes of the hadith that we took previously, the one who makes wudu on the day of Jumu'ah, فَبِهَا وَنِعْمَةً. Then this is sufficient and it is good. And the ghusl is afdal, the ghusl is better. Jayd. We have here also the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, مَنْ تَوَضَّعَ فَأَحْسَنَ الْوُضُوءَ ثُمَّ أَتَى الْجُمُعَةَ وَاسْتَمَعَ وَأَنْسَطْ غفر له ما بينه وبين الجمعة الأخرى ومن مس الحصى فقد لغى. The one who makes wudu and he perfects his wudu. Then he goes to the Jumu'ah and he listens, and he's silent and he listens attentively, he will be forgiven that which is between that Jumu'ah and the previous and the other Jumu'ah. And whoever touches the stones, the pebbles, فَقَدْ لَغَى, then his reward for the Jumu'ah will go to waste. And they also used the hadith of the entering of Uthman radiallahu anhu into the masjid when Umar, he was giving the khutbah, and Umar radiallahu anhu, he asked him if he had taken a ghusl. Naam, inshallah we'll take the hadith shortly, but this is also from the evidences which is mentioned by those who have held the opinion that it is recommended and it's not an obligation. So the Shaykh inshallah will go, after he clarifies that it is an obligation to make wudu, after he clarifies that it is an obligation to make ghusl, the Shaykh responds to the evidences which were presented as to say that the ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah is recommended. Firstly, the hadith of Samura, which indicates that the wudu is sufficient, and if a person performs ghusl, then this is better. He says that the hadith is weak. The hadith is weak hadith. And what is also possible that يحتمل أن يكون ذكر الوضوء لمن تقدم غسله على الذهب فاحتاج إلى إعادة الوضوء. He says another opinion is, if we say that the hadith is authentic, that what is intended is that the one who makes wudu, then the wudu is better. This is for the one who had previously made ghusl, and then he makes his wudu at that stage. And it's not binding upon him to make the ghusl, but it is better. And what is apparent that this is not totally clear, what strengthens that opinion, is that the hadith in it mentions, وَمَنْ اَغْتَسَلَ فَالْغُسُلْ أَفْضَلْ, and the one who performs the ghusl, then this is better. So we're not going to say that he has to do two ghusls, the ghusl which is an obligation and the ghusl which is recommended. There's only one ghusl for the day of Jumu'ah. So this other opinion that the Shaykh mentioned is not totally clear, but what is sufficient is that the hadith is da'if, it has any weakness. As they say, that this is from the tariq of Al-Hassan and Samura. Al-Hassan al-Basri, he reports from Samura ibn Jundub, وَلَمْ يَسْمَعْ مِنْهُ إِلَّا حَدِيثَ الْعَقِيقَ. He hasn't heard from the Sahabi Samura illa the, except the hadith of the Aqiqah. As for the other narrations which come from the Tariq of Al-Hasana and Samura, then the ulama al-Huffaz from the past, they have criticized these narrations. So this hadith is not something which can be used as a hujja, a proof for declaring the obligations which have passed us in the several hadith that we have taken and say that it is recommended. The first hadith is weak. He says also the hadith of Abi Huraira, interpreting it, we have the hadith which reads, whoever performs wudu and he perfects the wudu, then he comes to the day of Jumu'ah and he listens, he sits there attentively listening, then he will be forgiven. The Shaykh, he brings a benefit, which is that this hadith of Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, that this hadith has actually been reported from Abi Huraira in Sahih Muslim itself. It's been reported from the hadith of Abi Huraira with the same chain of narration which is leading to Abi Salih al-Samman, who reports from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, and the wording of the hadith reads, مَنْ اِغْتَسَلَ يَوْمَ الْجُمُعَةِ ثُمَّ أَتَى, the one who takes ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah and then comes. So this narration shows that the wording is he took a ghusl, and the other narration indicates wudu. So the Shaykh, he combines by saying that what is apparent is that the narration which reads the wudu, this is the wudu which is in the ghusl. The wudu which is in the ghusl and part of the ghusl, and it's not its own wudu. He says, otherwise, if it's not totally clear, then what is sufficient is the wording of man iqtasala, the one who does ghusl. And we will take this because this is in agreement with the other wordings which indicate the obligation of the ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah. Also Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah, in his Sahih, he mentions the hadith of Abi Huraira from another chain, and in it, it has a ghusl as opposed to the wudu, which further strengthens the opinion. So this second hadith is not clear hujjah. What remains with us is the hadith or the qissa of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu and Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. The Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he entered on the day of Jumu'ah when Umar, he was given a khutbah. فَأَنْكَرَ عَلَيْهِ عُمَرُ تَأَخُرَهُ. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he had criticized him for his delay. And Uthman radiallahu anhu, he said, O leader of the believers, مَا زِدْتُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تَوَضَّأْتُ بَعْدَ أَنْ سَمِعْتُ النِّدَاءُ I did not increase upon making wudu when I heard the call to the prayer, ثم أقبلت, then I came. Then Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, والوضوء أيضا, and also the wudu. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to command with ghusl, he used to command us with taking a bath, and all you did يعني was come with wudu. He says, وفي رواية أبي هريرة وقد علمت أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من جاء منكم الجمعة فليغتسل. And you have heard the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, the one who comes to the جمعة فليغتسل, then let him take a bath as a command. The Shaykh, he responds to this by saying, الشوكاني رحمه الله نيل الأوطار, he has responded to this by saying that I do not see in this any proof for the one who says that this is recommended, yani recommended to take a ghusl and it's not an obligation. He says, being that Umar radiallahu anhu criticizing this noble companion Uthman radiallahu anhu in front of this group is from the strongest of the opinions that it is an obligation. It was an obligation to take ghusl amongst them, yani amongst the Sahaba, this was known to them. And he goes on to mention that in this narration there's no taqreer, there's no acknowledgement from Umar radiallahu anhu as to Uthman radiallahu anhu coming to the Jumu'ah without making ghusl, but rather he had criticized this and he had mentioned it in front of this other group of companions who were there in front of him radiallahu anhum wa ardahum ajma'een. To the end of his speech, so we take from this that the evidences which have been mentioned to say that it is recommended to take ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah and it's not an obligation, but there are not evidences which are strong enough to reject the clarity of what has passed us and the previous evidences which show without a doubt that this is something which was known to the Sahaba radiallahu anhum and that the Messenger commanded them to take ghusl on that day of Jumu'ah. We take as a final benefit to the Masala, a tanbih, a notice which the Shaykh mentions, that Al-Khattabi rahimahullah ta'ala and other than him, they report an ijma', the consensus of the people of knowledge, that the ghusl, it is not a condition in the correctness of the prayer, and that the prayer will be correct without it. The prayer will be correct without ghusl. So if a person was to be delayed at work or for whatever reason, and they were incapable of taking the ghusl, and they came to the prayer of Jumu'ah, their prayer would be correct, but they would be falling into this error and mistake and sin by leaving off this obligation. So it is upon the Muslim to take his haytah, he takes his caution and he's wary. And the best way to get out of this problem is if a person wakes up for the Salatul Fajr on the day of Jumu'ah, after Fajr enters, that they take their ghusl then. They take their ghusl at that time. If they know they will be busy throughout the time of the day before they come to the prayer, then it is upon them to take their ghusl early so that they do not fall into any problem. And it's not for them to delay the ghusl and then say, you know, I have an excuse because I'm at work, after the clarity of the evidences have been presented. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to benefit by way of this. Wallahu A'lam wa Ahkam, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.